Today, Chef Kyle Anderson is baking orange cranberry bread with an orange glaze. Now, this holiday favorite can be perfect for gifts, even frozen until you're ready to eat it. And it smells like oranges up in here.
It does.
We're having fun.
We are. Also, I might add, this is great for muffins. If you want to make muffins, you can do muffins as well. Absolutely. It's a really versatile recipe. There are a couple of things real quick I want to go over with the recipe. It's already up on the website. It's a quick bread. It's super easy. The biggest thing is when you put in your butter at first, I like to use my hands, make it into just a perfect meal, get it dispersed all throughout. Then the other thing is just watch it in the oven. You want to be able to insert a knife and have it come clean. It is really simple, easy, but it's one of those where I know this time of year when everyone is so busy, and if you have multiple breads in the oven, so on, and you know you have like a 50-minute wait, all of a sudden it becomes 75 minutes, and you go in and, oh, geez, it's just a little burned. So set a timer and just kind of watch it.
Okay, good idea.
Okay, we are going to glaze here on camera, and really the secret to this, in my opinion, both for muffins and for the bread, is the glaze.
Okay.
This is the never-fail, foolproof, best orange glaze ever. We're going to start with a cup of confectioner's sugar, the powdered sugar. Mm-hmm. Kind of put that in our bowl. This is so easy.
How many sticks of butter are you putting in this time?
We're not putting any in.
Oh, how many went into this?
Not as much as you think. Actually, there is a quarter cup, or that's about a, what, a half a stick?
Okay, that's it. That's not bad.
It's not.
Especially
if you look at the ingredients, this is fairly healthy. Okay, to this, we're going to add some orange juice. Now, here's another trick that is in this as well as this. You don't have to do it, but if you use a little orange juice concentrate and make it a little bit stronger, it'll boost your orange flavor, and that's kind of important, especially if you're going to use it in the freezer, like pop it in and pull it back out. The other thing about freezing this recipe is you want to glaze it just before you give it. Don't glaze it, then freeze it.
Okay. How much orange juice?
We have 4 tablespoons in here. We're going to put in about 3, and you know how I like to do my abouts. Okay. And then we're going to reserve this one just in case we need a little bit more liquid. And we're going to whisk that into our powdered sugar. See how easy this is?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then to this, and now this, I'm going to let you make an executive decision. You get to kind of cook.
Okay.
Okay, are you in more of an orange extract or a vanilla extract mood?
Orange extract.
Orange extract, so we're going to go for extra orange flavor.
Okay.
Okay, very small amount. And you can use either orange or vanilla. And I mean, we're putting maybe about a quarter teaspoon in here.
Wow. Okay.
Okay. And then to this, so we've been zesting and grating over there.
Yeah. Got this whole plate full for you.
There you go. All right. So we're
ready for this?
Add our zest.
Okay.
Actually, we don't need quite all that zest, but a good, probably, I like about 3 tablespoons. We're going to add that into our glaze.
So we've got orange juice, orange zest, and orange extract.
It is very orange.
Orangey.
It is orangey. That's what we want. Okay, so we'll fold all that together, and then in a matter of seconds, we have actually made our orange glaze.
Yeah, that looks great.
Okay, so these could go either on the muffins or on the bread. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this bread. Oh, do you want it just, you want it directly on your piece? We can make that happen.
Okay. Whatever you want. You do what's ever easiest.
Okay, now
whatever's
you will
less
note
messy.
The chopped cranberries show up beautifully. You can also see all of the orange zest in there.
And this recipe's on the website, right?
Try a little glaze.
Okay. KFOR.com, of course.
Can't beat it.
Where you can always find Kyle's recipes. I gotta get a little piece. Because you know the carbs.
Oh, the carbs.
Very good.
All right.
Kyle, that's so orangey. I love it. Again, KFOR.com for the recipe. Thank you, sir.
Always a pleasure.